As you can see, the receiver itself is pretty simple. Extend the Broadcast Receiver class and override the OnReceive handler, as you can see here. Receivers are lightweight components meant to listen for broadcasts, react, and complete within 5 seconds. That usually means simply starting a service or sending a notification. To have your receiver start listening for broadcasts, you need to register it, either through an entry in your manifest like this, or dynamically, within another application component, usually in activity, like this. Then you define the intent filter that specifies the broadcast event you want to receive. You can do that either here in the manifest, or if you're registering your receiver with an application component, such as an activity, you can create your new intent filter like this. The biggest difference between manifest and dynamic receivers is when they're triggered. A programmatically registered receiver will only receive broadcasts while the app is running, while a manifest declared receiver will start your app specifically to receive your broadcasts. For example, I usually code with my noise-cancelling headphones on, so a music app like this might want to register a runtime receiver to listen for the system intent broadcast that announces when headphones are unplugged. That will allow it to automatically pause playback when the audio routing switches from headphones to speakers. In this case, we can use a runtime receiver because the app is guaranteed to be running if music is playing. On the other hand, if I'm using Google Cloud Messaging to listen for new data from my server, I'll want to register a manifest receiver that always listens for incoming tickles from my server and will wake up my app if it's been terminated to trigger the update code, usually a sync adapter, which is something we'll discuss later in Lesson 6. There's a bunch of system broadcasts you can monitor to help your app react to changes in the system. You can see the system broadcast actions within the intent documentation at developer.android.com. One great use for broadcast receivers is to monitor for changes to internet connectivity or charging status. Imagine your app has to upload a movie or calculate the next 10,000 moves in a game of chess. How might you use a receiver to wait until the device is plugged in before starting that process? Should it be a manifest receiver or a broadcast receiver?